So, pick it up, poop. Pick it up, dung. It's a thing. Disgusting. Freaking disgusting. Absolutely disgusting. hey everybody, welcome back to Let's Play Xenoblade Chronicles X Blind. Well, blind, Let's Play Blind, not everything else. Wilkin Levias. Yeah, absolutely no condition to fight that thing. Just happened to spot it out of convenience. Shadow Atsikula. Man, they really wanted me to level up here, don't they? And, in the last episode, we pretty much joined the Blade, officially. And, well, pretty much on a mission. Monarch Cherry. Something like that, I don't know. Walk Orange! What? Is it an orange walk or something? I don't know. Just gotta get going. South Gen Pass BC. Data pool path there, but I don't know. I really can't seem to reach it. I mean, maybe I could, maybe I don't, but. Whoa. Okay, geez. Geez, that's my being devised there, geez. I was just trying to figure out where the heck I was going. No, oh, I again. Okay, die, dude. Thank you for dying. Have a nice day. We'll get in time. Oh, come on. Exactly what I don't want. Wanting to get too much enemies. Alright, so if I can finally put words without having that much enemy smacking up the building out of nowhere, I keep wanting to climb stuff. That's probably either a good thing or a bad thing, but considering this is a bad thing, I probably shouldn't. Shut up.
Damn. I knew we would have heard from them by now.
It was definitely fighting something. But this damage, it's not the usual claw or bite marks.
No signs of the team. If they were eaten, we'd know it. So did they walk away, or were they taken? Right. Either way, they couldn't have gotten very far. Let's keep looking.
Hold up, Elma. Check this out. I'm picking up an Earth-based IFF signal coming from that direction. It's Pathfinder.
That thing over there, maybe?
It doesn't look natural, does it?
No, it doesn't. It looks like trouble.
And look at this. I'm picking up readings for other life forms, too. Multiple signals, moving around inside the structure. Elma, you don't think...
you're right. Look at their movements. They're controlled, orderly. They're definitely not wild animals. Now the question is, are they native to Mira? Or are they visitors like us? And if so, from where?
You think it's one of the forces that destroyed Earth?
Let's not jump to any conclusions. It's a big universe out there. Of course, we shouldn't rule it out either.
Should we call this into HQ?
Yes, but not from here. If we're picking up their signals, they might be close enough to intercept ours.
You there! Drop your weapons!
Stay calm. We don't want to provoke them.
Earth aliens! Surrender! Now!
They know about Earth? You may have been right after all, Lin.
Negotiating probably would be pointless.
Stand down! Did you already forget my first lesson? Fighting is a last resort. Our friends here appear to be able to speak our language. Which means we need to find out if diplomacy is a viable option.
You're right.
We come in peace, and we're willing to negotiate. If you have any Earth alien prisoners, we'd ask the conditions for their release. If you don't, we'll leave you in peace.
No negotiations. No conditions. We have our orders. All Earth aliens must die.
Told you they wouldn't listen to Ethan. Bone scout. They wouldn't listen to reason. I don't imagine. They were pretty obvious in what they were trying to do. Trying to freaking kill us. Kill us really dead. But of course, that's good. It's just good. There we go. We're dead.
So much for the diplomatic approach. What's the deal with wanting us all dead anyway?
Yeah, I wonder. They did mention they were following orders. Maybe someone higher up their chain of command would be willing to negotiate.
Quite. I saw the base, it's just for the Pathfinder. And stop. Humanoid Flyer 3. But nothing for the win. I can see what a power. Oh, I can't really do that. Feel still. Alright, ground gorilla.
I just care that he wasn't right there. I could say half of it. I mean, the badness was actually half of it. Then can you get upstairs on this?
What about him? Okay,
nice try again.
No, nothing. Oh, I probably want to change the armor.
I did it!
Oh, what?
Oh.
What?
Oh.
Lin, can you give us an approximate location for that IFF signal?
Huh. Let's see.
This guy just got like stabbed and stuff. What? What did you get?
Seems to be originating from that building over there.
Then we better get moving. There's no time to lose.
And his eye, oh, a red. Oi. Next.
Whoa! I did not see that there. What the heck? On Pugilif. Now. Moving on, moving on. Domestic armored suit. Killing time! Kidding me, that thing was gonna join in the battle anyway. That was stupid. I'm just running. Oh, come on. This freaking game, man. This doesn't want me to do anything when I want to. I mean, clearly it's on the level. That level 10 enemy decided to come up. Just decided to. Just couldn't let me do what I want to do without having to intervene. Ay. Anyways, let's do this at a lot more of a better attempt, not provoking those enemies over there. Here on the staff phone.
We got it. Let's move.
This is biological. Alright.
I did it.
Obtained the titanium knife. Nice. Could actually use a better upgrade at a time like this.
No, you see how I got around
it. I was about to say, that's no difference, but that actually looks pretty freaking amazing. Dang. Well, of course, now I can wear this. Still got nothing for the suit, though. That's kind of disappointing, but. Oh, whatever. Gotta keep moving. Just gotta get up somehow. Okay, I think we go over here. And try to avoid anything at mass.
Flame grenade!
Okay. Ah, boom. Okay, I'll fight that one. Finish off.
Nice work.
Alright. Alright, level 8, not bad. Got some pawn pooches. Might as well fight them. They're in the way. As soon as you get one of them, you take care of the other one. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Thank you. Now time to take care of this one. I missed that again. I'm gonna wait for the charge up. Go. That one off. Come on, level up. It's true on any point. Pretty nice. Alright. So, let's go inside this building.
More fluent than the others. Are you in charge?
I am called Glednar. I command this squad, Earth Alien. Now it is time for you to surrender.
Hello, Glednar. I am called Elma, and I command this squad. If this planet is your home, we apologize for intruding. We crash-landed here after our ship was damaged in an attack by unknown adversaries. We were hoping we could negotiate a peaceful settlement in exchange for our friends, but...
Peaceful settlement? Your words are wasted on us. All we can promise Earth aliens is a swift death.
Alma.
Right. We tried. Looks like survival of the fittest it is. Fine then. Seeing as you know we come from Earth, I'm guessing there's a good chance we might have a score to settle with you anyway.
Here we are, Lenor and his squad. I'm just gonna Whoa, invisible wall man. None of them heal. And there we go, he is down. Now we'll get to take out the ruffian from here. There we go. We are done for.
I don't get it. Why would they be so bent on killing all humans?
Who can say? Whatever the reason, this is dire news. We should let the others know ASAP. Let's call it in and head back to HQ for a full debrief.
Roger that. And here I just started to hope we'd finally escaped all this.
Escape! Yes, escape! Tatsu also won escape! Friends! Friends that leave Tatsu trapped!
More Xenos? What should we do?
Stay back, Lane. What do you think, Rook?
Finally! Dance of Freedom! Tatsu thanks you!
Interesting. One of the vegetables is sentient.
Talking potato? I wonder if it tastes different, too.
I know what we're having for dinner tonight. You don't know it yet, new guy, but I'm a pretty mean cook.
You are mean! Mean and cruel! Tatsu definitely not potato! Tatsu explained this to dumb and smelly prone when they take Tatsu, but prone not listen! Crow never listen. Oh, Nopon blue day prone first set sticky feet on Mira. Especially Tatsu. Tatsu witnessed prone abuse firsthand. At this rate, entire Nopon race in danger. Yes, Nopon are endangered species. So really, friends have social responsibility to protect Tatsu from danger.
Uh-huh. What do you think, Elma? Bake or fry?
Wait a minute. The beings who captured you, big brutes in armor? Little pointy ears?
Yes, prone!
And they're a more recent arrival here, is that right? They're not native to this planet?
Not native, recent! If friends want more details, friends must promise to protect Tatsu. Only then will Tatsu talk.
Right. Elma, you hold him. I'll peel.
Tatsu will talk! Tatsu will talk! Friends not get no one's sense of humor resolved!
So if I understand correctly, this is your homeworld. The Nopon people are native to Mira. And then just recently, the prone show up and quickly hunt you to the edge of extinction. Is that right?
Not just prone. Prone and their nasty, evil buddies. Lots and lots of them.
Their buddies? You mean other alien races?
Other hungry alien races. They all gang up on Nopon. They do horrible, terrible things to Nopon. Someday, Tatsu will turn tables and eat them for a change.
Oh, hungry at Tatsu.
Then you'll help Tatsu? Protect Tatsu? Oh, happy day! It's settled then. In return, Tatsu will accompany friends back to their village.
What do you think? Take him with us?
He seems harmless enough. And he'd be a good source of information on Mira and the Crow. All right. We can debrief him when we report to Commander Vander. As long as he passes the quarantine scan, we can bring him back to New LA.
Right. Let's get that out of the way. All clear.
Then Tatsu can join friends? Dance of joy! New friends are friendliest friends ever! I know! Tatsu has special thank you gift for friends, for saving Tatsu's life! Tatsu will lend it to friends for free!
Lend? It's not a gift if you don't give it.
Give it away? For always? For free? This would be insulting to friends and to Tatsu! No Nopon merchant worth his salt and pepper could do such a thing! Tatsu is grateful, but Tatsu not insane!
What? It's insane to think if someone saves your life, you might actually show them some real... And he's not even listening.
Friend, do you ever get lost? Tired of bulky maps and flawed memory?
Tell Tatsu they're not all who want to lost. There's gotta be a better way.
There is a better way. Friends, this is your lucky day. Presenting Follow Ball. Follow Ball is number one ultimate best super secret must-have Nopon item. If friends get lost out in wild, friends just follow Ball of Light to safety. And now it's yours, for free, tomorrow! For now, anyway.
Really? Follow Ball? That's the best name you could come up with for your super special thing?
Meh? What would friend prefer? Fancy name no one understands so friend can feel smart? Now, time for Nopon Dance of Generosity!
I don't know. Is that thing really gonna be all that useful? What if it's a trap, or boom, it just blows up in our faces?
Ah yes, that reminds Tatsu. If Follow Ball get damaged, Tatsu need to charge friend's full price, plus restock fee.
So much for Dance of Generosity.
Oh, finally we get something out for the soldiers. Fans survival concert twice. You should think Follow Ball before you think Follow Ball, select a person friend want guidance for. Follow Ball is super because you need it for one person, but also total junk if no mission is selected. Oh, and Follow Ball sometimes gets lost, so try to go easy on Follow Ball. It's pretty smart for the most part. It is pretty much all it takes. Alright, so we have thoughts to do. Who is an Nopon? And he's no potato! Wait, what is that? That is 38, Drone Walk Kuo. Dang. I'm gonna go ahead and do ground gear really quick so we can equip that piece of new equipment. Not bad. With all the gone thingy. I love it.
Ow. Nice.
Anyways, let's go to New LA and super walk back to the raid barracks if I can do that. If I can do it correctly, jeez.
My
hand is stuck in the bar. And here we are. Let's go on in. Hello? Long way. I have absolutely no. Oh, he's right there.
Damn, losing Nelson's team is a real blow. But the fact we're not the only visitors on this rock is even worse.
They made it clear they want all humans dead. For all we know, they may be related to the forces that destroyed Earth and followed us here.
Wonderful. I'll report this to Secretary Nagi. See if we can't bolster our defenses. Just one last thing. What the bloody hell is this dancing turnip doing here?
He's actually a potato.
Tatsu, not turnip or potato. For last time, Tatsu is not food. Now, on behalf of planet Lyra, Tatsu welcome all Earth people and offer a friendly treaty of friendship.
Yeah, right. Anyway, we were thinking he could be a good source of general intel about the planet. Exactly how useful that'll be remains to be seen.
Oh, don't you worry about a thing. Friend's totally safe now that Tatsu is in town. Tatsu watch over and protect friends, especially weak, pathetic Linley with her thin, bony wings.
You mean my arms? Look who's talking. And who said anything about you coming with us? You can stay here, you greedy, annoying little cabbage. I'm sure there's a salad here that could use you.
Meh-meh? Tatsu, stay here! Friends would leave Tatsu behind?
It's for the best. You said yourself your people are endangered, and the Xenos that captured you might still be out there. You'll be safest here in the city.
Agreed.
Tatsu not agreed! Friends will want Tatsu along. Friends need Tatsu along.
How so?
What? Well, that, of course. This planet have many helpful Nopon that Tatsu can talk to. Other Nopon can share information for friends.
That might be useful.
That right. Most Nopon not like Tatsu. Nopon can be shy. Nopon can be difficult. Most Nopon never trust friends or even talk to friends. But Tatsu? Nopon love Tatsu. But Tatsu use smooth talk and winning personality to get friends good info.
The tater tot has a point.
More like an ulterior motive, if you ask me.
Tatsu, perish the thought. Tatsu intentions are pure, Linley. Pure as snow. Linley intimidated by Tatsu's strength and smarts, but do not worry, Tatsu is true friend.
Strength and smarts, huh? That's really not what I'm worried about here.
All right, then it's settled. Small Fry here will accompany you three out in the field. After all, we can use all the info we can get.
Seriously? We have to babysit this thing?
You're the ones who picked him up. Besides, would you really want to leave him with another team?
Maybe not. Unless we were invited to the meal, I mean.
See? Already getting along like peas and carrots. He can be your charge, Lin.
Oh, come on, Commander! That's not funny! I've got my hands full out there! This is so unfair. Back me up here, would you, Elma?
I'm sure Elma has no objections.
Right. As you say, Commander.
Done and done. Welcome to Blade, Tater. We'll be counting on you.
Yes, sir! And it's a Tatsu. Oh, one thing Tatsu forgot to mention. Nopon are pacifists, so friends need to defend Tatsu, keep extra super safe in any battle. Tatsu, VIP diplomat, after all.
Why am I not surprised? So much for him watching over and protecting us.
Are we missing? He's pretty much done. And Pima's already done chapter 3 too.
So, Rook, feel like you're starting to get the hang of things?
Of course you are. You've taken to it like a fish to water, just like Elma and the Commander said you would.
Just the same, let's review the key points, and I can fill in some extra details. Blade's top priority right now is to secure missing pieces of the Lifehold You remember that much. Countless people are frozen in the life hold. It's the key to restoring humanity. Up until we ran into the prone, our biggest concern was that wild indigents would stumble on the life hold and damage it somehow. But now there's a more pressing threat, intelligent alien races who are intentionally trying to destroy us. So, our search has new urgency. We need to find and retrieve all of the life hold ASAP.
And the best way to do that is by expanding the reach of Frontier Nav. The more probes we can install, the wider we can scan, and the faster we can find bits of the life hold.
So our primary focus going forward should be to travel around Mira installing data probes. As many as we can, as fast as we can. I can't stress enough how important this is. You still with me? Good. Then let's move on to the other pressing threat that Blade has to deal with. Hostile indigens. There's no real delicate way to put this. Any wildlife that poses a clear threat must be eliminated. The life hold is our future, but we can't ignore the present. We still have our duty to keep New LA safe. And sometimes that duty requires enacting coordinated strikes to solve problems before they can do real harm.
We're the newcomers here, it's true. And they're usually just out to defend their territory. But sometimes it really is them or us. And we have to make sure it's us. Don't get me wrong. It's not like we run out there and light up anything that moves. Only Blade HQ can choose targets, and they tend to keep them strictly to creatures that pose a significant threat to our survival.
In order to contribute to this cause, operatives are asked to form into squads to take on special missions. These squad missions, as we call them, don't get posted to Mission Control like your other more typical assignments. Rather, HQ transmits the details directly to all of us at the same time. Basically, they want as many people to know about them ASAP, so they can be taken care of ASAP.
I'm sure you can imagine that these missions aren't your run-of-the-mill little fetch quests. It's not the kind of stuff just one or two Blades can handle on their own. That's why squads can have as many as 32 members.
And it's why we ask members to sign up to a squad beforehand. We can't have Blades playing musical chairs whenever this kind of emergency hits us. But just remember, squad missions are not mandatory. You don't have to drop everything you're doing just to take one on. HQ has no way of knowing what every Blade is up to when these missions arise. If you're busy with something else, they'll understand. They need to trust our collective judgment with these things, and, well, so far so good.
And I think that about covers the basics, right?
Search for the missing pieces of the life hold. Install data probes to expand Frontier Nav. And take on squad missions when you can to keep us safe. Got all that? Good. We're counting on you.
And briefing adjourned. Thank God.
All right, well, it's getting pretty late, isn't it?
Yeah, let's call it a night.
Oh, Tatsu's so excited to sleep in real bed. Lily can show Tatsu to his room now.
Oh, your room is right over there.
Oh-hoo! It's the perfect size for Tatsu. Wait, what? Tatsu know what that is? That refrigerator eater. Won't go in there to cool off.
I guess you are smarter than you look.
Tatsu not want to brag, but... wait a minute! Tatsu see what Lily did there!
Tatsu, you're gonna be the next up on the next VP. Alright, so in Fast 6 story missions, at last the Blade adventure begins. Main stories can be undertaken via Blade barracks, but remember that they come with specific requirements like level and survey rate. Good luck, Luke. We're counting on you to find the Life Ford Core. I'm Shadow, working hard. Ben's been working hard lately. Tatsu must know all about it. Anyways, we can now have. We can now get up to new features. This is the Blade Core system. I'll be operated to interact with their info. This is for an emissions of fire, so even. I will meet with affection if you so desire. Next up, this Blade Scout feature. And now we can edit our readings, so. Phantom's advice. Once you hit class rank 10, you might want to think about changing classes. Moving from sister to a higher class will allow you to use skills. Oh, well, remember, you can change classes anytime, so don't be afraid to try something new. You are playing now. It's great responsibility, but also great freedom. And though some assignments require specific party members who you take on your travels is generally up to you, go on in on myself anytime you like. We'll be in the barracks. And just settings, don't really care. And wow. Those who wanted to invest a single player experience, those who wanted to focus on multiplayer play, those who wanted to play with special favorites. I think it'd just be here. The whole of NLA is counting on you. New characters can join your party. Thankful for encounters. And, wow, so many things. So many things going on. Jeez. Wait, jeez, so much stuff. Jeez, crossed on it. Haven't even gotten to the bulk of the rest of stuff. But yeah, I think that'll do it for now. Next time on Let's Play Xenoblade Chronicles X, we will be, well, finally taking a break and doing some business and whatnot. See you guys then, I suppose. But not before I end my social greetings.